Red pants on a red carpet, bold move. Awkward. I'm a professional magician, and I've been doing magic for 35 years. And today, I'm going to teach all of you how to create real miracles in three easy steps. Let me back up. For the first 30 years of my career, after I do a show like this, one of the most asked questions is, what is your favorite magic trick? And I thought it was this. Hi, you in the front row. What's your name? Yes, I can see you. This is not television. What is it?
Joe,
I've got 52 cards here. Give it a little shuffle. Would you pick a secret card, Joe, by saying the word stop as I go through the deck? Take a look at this card, memorize the card, concentrate on the card, hold it close to your body, sit down, Joe. I'll show you, cards are all different. Joe, look into my eyes. Are you concentrating on the card? Okay. And then I would read Joe's mind. And I would tell him what card he's thinking of. But then I realized it's the wrong question. If I want to create miracles, about 5 years ago, I realized the correct question is, what is the best magic trick? And in my research, I came across this book by Henning Nelms. And it's very easy to miss. On page 6, in two little paragraphs, he actually gave me the answer of how to create miracles. I'll explain. The ham sandwich. Imagine you and I are walking on the street, and you find out I'm a magician. And you say, could you do a trick? I go, yes. Look in your pocket. You look in your pocket and you pull out a ham sandwich. You go, that's odd. But if we're walking down the street and it's lunchtime and you're looking for a place that sells a ham sandwich and you find out I'm a magician, you say, could you do a trick? Yes. Look in your pocket. You pull out a ham sandwich. It's a miracle. So the three easy steps are this. What you do is you predict every possible thing your audience may say, think, or do. Then you prepare for everyone that's humanly possible. And then if the occasion arises, you present it. That's how you create a miracle, and that's how a magician's mind works. I'll give you an example of a ham sandwich. We're gonna use technology. Hi, you in the second row.
Hi.
It looks like polka dots, it's hard to see. Hi, what's your name?
Felicia,
in a moment, I'm going to ask you to think of a name of technology, so I'll get you ready. I want you to think of a technology that when it came out and you used it, it felt like magic.
Siri,
the voice assistant. Okay, this is going to get meta. How many people have Siri? I'm going to do this on my phone, and you guys can do it in parallel, too. We're going to search Siri for who created Siri. Hey, Siri. Search the web for who created Siri.
I found this on the web.
Okay. Big speak. Who is it? It looks like, I got it. It's a person named Adam Cheyer. Let's see what it looks like. Okay, challenge accepted. For you, Felicia, a miracle. Music, please. Ladies and gentlemen, Adam Cheyer, the creator of Siri. Hey, Adam, let me get you out of that box.
Thank you.
Hey, Elon, Mr. Gates, we don't need you anymore. You can go home. So, Adam, I was just telling this audience on how to create a ham sandwich, a miracle experience for the audience. Are you familiar with that concept?
I've been using that concept for years, not in magic, but in technology. Actually, let me give you a few examples.
Okay.
Of these stories. Please, I need a little more room. I don't need you anymore, Robert.
Are you serious? Adam frickin' Cheyer.
So, the ham sandwich has helped me tremendously in my career. Let me give you an example. So in around 2002, I was working on a predecessor of Siri. This was the time of Blackberries, not iPhones. And we were presenting to Marc Benioff, the CEO of Salesforce.com. And at the time, they had no mobile solution. We said, if you could just ask any question and remotely access and control all of your Salesforce account, that would be incredible. And you don't have a mobile solution. So he said, yes, I'm very interested. But then he thought, we were in the boardroom, he said, what if this could also be used for our real product, our website? And I'm like, what an interesting idea. So I said, go ahead, let's bring up a web browser, let's log in, and just see what that would look like. And there was, this is Salesforce 2002, there was a search box, you could type in requests and get back links. And through a little magic of technology, we had enabled something that would let us transform the page. And right then, it changed from a search box into our control center, where we could type natural language queries and get full reports generated instead of just links. And he was blown away, since it was his idea. He ran down the hall. He started pulling executives out of meetings. He says, you got to come see this. And then we ended up selling our technology to become the Salesforce.com wireless edition around 2002, 2003. So that was, you know, a huge use of the ham sandwich to make a sale. Here's an example, a second example. We started Siri as a small company that had an app in the App Store, and it could enable many web services. So we went to see Barry Diller of IAC, who had so many different properties, Match.com, Evite, many, many more. We said, wow, talk to one guy, we can enable all his services. But one of his properties was also Ask. And he said, what would it be like if Siri and Jeeves were to get together? And we're like, good question. Again, brought up the website, went to ask.com, did standard search type things, and then magic transformation. Siri was amazingly embedded into the site. Now you could buy tickets and do all of these things that a search engine can't do. And a final example is Siri on the iPhone. When it came out, it was focused on email and text messaging. But we anticipated people might ask other things, like, Siri, when is your birthday? Tomorrow, by the way, is actually the 8th birthday of Siri on iPhone. Or, Siri, do you love me? And we put in all of those Easter eggs, right? And with that, when Siri came out, people loved it, but not only for the functionality, all of those funny things that you could say. And it went viral. Every talk show had Siri. And so really having the ham sandwich concept was, you know, fundamental to why we now have things like Alexa and Google Assistant and Bixby today. So those are three short examples of ham sandwiches, or in the Easter egg case, the ham and egg sandwich. To close, was there someone here who had picked a card, just thought of a card? Could you stand up, please? Don't say the card. Okay, and now think of it in a loud voice. For the first time, please say the name of your card.
It was the Four of Diamonds.
The Four of Diamonds. And we have the Four of Diamonds.
To conclude. Thank you. If you want to create a miracle, all you have to do is predict every possible thing that the person you're performing for is going to say, think, or do. Prepare for all possible combinations. If it presents itself, then you present it. And that's how you create miracles. Thank you. What's that?
I want the ham sandwich.
There's one in every crowd. Was like that on bagel, rye, wheat. You let me know. I've got it prepared here for every single possibility. So If you're creating a presentation, if you're giving a job interview, if you are even making breakfast for your family, be prepared. You'll create a miracle. Thank you, Sam.